At the beginning of my career, I just wanted to be outside. I wanted to work in the woods. And here I am at the end of a career, focused very aggressively on just one aspect of the whole thing, which is keeping forest land in forest cover. Because without that, all the benefits that flow from a forest are lost. I'm what's called the regional silviculturist, and I have program manager responsibility for the reforestation program here in California.
Good job, man. Good job.
This job covers a whole state. There's 20 million acres of national forest, and about 10 million of them are forested. These systems evolved under fire regimes
that benefit these forests. But now, these fires are burning at high severity and scale. And I'll tell you, the thing that disturbs me the most is the great big burned out holes after the large wildfires. And so I pretty much dedicated the rest of my career to reforestation efforts after these big burns. Mm. And today is a day we get to be outside in places where we were before and see how things have changed over time, both with and without our help.
That's right.
And you were a part of that.
Cleveland Fire is important to me because it was fairly early in my career, and it was a place that you and I have been here shortly after the fire burned, and now we get to look at some of the consequences of the work we did 20 years ago.
During that same time period, the agency shifted principal focus to ecological restoration. And by ecological restoration, what I mean is the assisted recovery of ecosystems that have been degraded, damaged, or destroyed. And before that fire, that whole slope looked like that piece that's over there on the right. But this is a place where people practiced some ecological restoration. This is a place where recovery has been assisted through a variety of efforts. And we can see the pine trees behind us that are now 30 feet tall or so, some 20 years after the fire. And this is an example of a condition that's possible if we try to help things out. And now we can go and look at some other places where we're not planting trees, where we're not assisting recovery. And 20 years after the fire, without any help, we still have some pines, some oaks, and some shrubs and grasses. So is this good or is this bad? What do we want public forest to be like? You know, what kind of condition are we trying to create 30, 40, 50 years from now?
It's a tough question to answer because there's a lot of different opinions out there. Mine's really is one of them, and I'm trying to capture the desires and needs of the owners of this land, the American public.
Ultimately, though, resiliency is the goal. And that means to put this forest back into a condition where it's better able to withstand future disturbances on its own. And this forest is relatively resilient.
Yep.
In other words, if there were a ground fire, it's going to do good here.
Fire would probably stay on the ground, burn with short flames, and burn up some fuels, and probably leave the trees standing perfectly healthy.
And then you've got a system that's functioning more like the one that this whole area evolved with.
That's right, yeah.
We're trying to create and maintain productive ecosystems for the benefit of people now and for future generations.
Okay, that one is 1.8 feet, Tally Man.
This is a gift that we give the future that lasts a very long time.
So the buds are.
I look back on this, on all this, and I think, you know, if I had this to do over again, I think I'd make this same choice. I'd still be a forester. I'd still do this kind of work.